Honorable Ulama Ikram, respected brothers and elders, mothers and sisters, we know very well that every person that comes in this dunya is desirous of a good stay and a pleasant stay in this dunya. The believer believes that he will be questioned in the grave and ultimately he will have to stand up before Allah and either a positive statement or decision will be made for him or either Jahannam. That is why he is desirous of a good stay in this dunya, a wonderful stay in the qabr, and a favorable decision on the day of Qiyamah. A kafir only believes in this dunya, so his desire is that as long as I live, till my last breath, I must have a good, healthy, prosperous, blissful life. Now just as this is our desire, wallah, this is the very same desire that Allah has for his entire creation, that how our life in this world can be wonderful, can be a pleasure, our stay in the grave can be wonderful, and likewise a favorable decision can be made for us on the day of Qiyamah. The only difference is that unfortunately, what Allah Rabbul Izzat out of His complete and divine knowledge has decided and defined as a good life for us, man out of his ignorance and arrogance has decided the direct opposite as a good life for himself. What Allah has defined and decided is good for you, man out of his ignorance and arrogance, إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. Allah says man is ignorant. He has decided the direct opposite. And as long as he will not shift from his thinking and come back onto the divine guidance of Allah, he will suffer in this dunya and akhirat. Allah Rabbul Izzat out of his divine knowledge said that zina is haram. وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشًا وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. Allah said, zina is evil, do not come close to it, it is immorality and it is the most evil path. Man felt that this was putting an end to his, this was restricting his freedom. The freedom that Allah had given him, he felt that Allah was interfering with his freedom. So he felt that zina must be made available and accessible, because of which Allah brought about this killer sickness, which is taking the lives of thousands of people. And if we take our conference that was held in the country now 2 weeks ago, the outcome of the conference was not to stop zina or fornication, but rather the drug that is available to challenge the sickness, must, the price of it must be reduced. That was the outcome of the conference where billions of rands was invested. The sickness that has come about is directly related to the violation of the orders of Allah. Take the aspect of polygamy, which the West disapproves of. But up to this day, there isn't one incident where a man developed AIDS because of having relation with three women which were in his nikah through proper sahih nikah. Whereas today a man having relation with two women develops the illness, not because having relation with two women, but having relation with two women unlawfully, illegally. Take the Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam that came prior. Apart from Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sulaiman alayhi salam, according to the riwayat of Muslim Sharif, had 100 wives. And as long as man will not understand that this is because of deviating from the command of Allah, he will keep on paying the price. What we've seen is the tip of the iceberg. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا فَشَ الزِّنَا فِي قَوْمٍ كَثُرَ فِيهِمُ الْمَوْتِ. When zina will become prevalent, death will become prevalent and common. The teachings of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the teachings of Allah and Allah's Nabi is so clear that الزَّانِيَةُ وَالزَّانِي فَجْلِدُوا كُلَّ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْهُمَا مِئَةَ جَلْدًا. That adulteress and adulterer, when the zina is confirmed, then give them 100 lashes. And Allah says, وَلَا تَأْخُذْكُمْ بِهِمَا رَأْفَةٌ فِي دِينِ اللَّهِ. When carrying out this command of Allah, let not mercy overpower you in lashing these people, because kindness to the criminal is oppression to the innocent. And Allah's hukam with regards to zina is very different. Generally in Islam, the ahkam demand tasattur, cover it, conceal it in a very discreet manner. But with regard to the penalty of zina, the Quran says, وَلْيَشْهَدَ عَذَابَهُمَا طَائِفَةٌ مِّنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. When zina has been confirmed, announce the venue and let the believers come and witness the consequences of the violation of the divine command of Allah. In the time of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when this act happened, and that woman Imra'atul Ghamidiyya came to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you and I will be responsible, respected brothers and mothers. A man, Allah has given him so much, that never mind him, his generations to come can live off the wealth that he has. What has happened to us? Are we dying out of poverty that we have to send our daughters to these institutions where they have been targeted with nasty and evil glances from morning till evening? One alim asked, one brother told an alim, Mawlana, make dua for my daughter. She's studying in university. Make dua, Allah must keep her chaste. So Mawlana said, bhai, you are asking me to make dua for a person that is walking in water, his feet mustn't be wet. That's what you are asking me. A man walking in water, his feet must not be wet. That's the question you are asking me. O Nabi of Allah, inni zanaytu fa'aqim alayya al-hadda. I have committed zina, but restlessness has come about into me, O Nabi of Allah. According to the Islamic ruling, because nikah was performed, so rajam will take place, pelt me, O Nabi of Allah. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who came as a mercy unto mankind, said that you have committed the wrong, we cannot be cruel to that innocent fetus that is in your womb. When you deliver the child, then you come back to me. After this woman delivers this child, if she wanted, she could have said, I came to the Nabi of Allah. But this is the pure, clean teachings of Islam. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, he inquires, the Sahaba asks, أَيُّ شَيْءٍ خَيْرٌ لِلنِّسَى. What is best for women? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, go and ask Fatima radiallahu anha. When Fatima radiallahu anha was questioned with this question, she said, O Nabi of Allah, لا يرين الرجال ولا يرونهن. The best gift that any father can give to his daughter or any brother to his sister or any husband to his wife, the Nabi of Allah on the tongue of the queen of the woman of Jannah, لا يرين الرجال ولا يرونهن. That her sight does not fall on any strange man, and no strange man's sight falls on her. أَقْرَبُ مَا تَكُونُ مِنْ وَجْهِ رَبِّهَا وَهِيَ فِي قَعْرِ بَيْتِهَا. The Nabi of Allah says, there is no piece of land on the face of this earth, be it Makkah or Medina, where a woman can enjoy the closeness of her Allah more than her house. The closest any woman is to her Allah is when she is in the confines of a house. That is why the poet says, Ya Ukhti, La Tarfa'i Anki Al-Khimara Fatandami. Ya Ukhti, La Tarfa'i Anki Al-Khimara Fatandami. Suni Jamalaki In Aratti Karama. O my sister, don't remove that veil if you want the honor of Allah that He has preserved for you on the day of Qiyamah. Suni Jamalaki, preserve your beauty and restrict it for your husband and no one else. Today, unfortunately, Allah forgive us, because the male is smiling with so much strange woman, when he comes home, there's no more energy left for him to smile with his wife. Why? Because from morning, from the time he caught the bus, in his lunch break, in his office hours, behind his counter, he was only smiling with strange woman. So when he comes home, he hasn't got time to smile with that woman that is anxiously anticipating his arrival. تبارك وتعالى في القرآن المجيد والفرقان الحميد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم من عمل صالحا من ذكر أو أنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة ولنجزينهم أجرهم بأحسن ما كانوا يعملون وقال تعالى في مقام آخر
ومن أعرض عن ذكري فإن له معيشة ضنكا ونحشره يوم القيامة أعمى قال رب لم حشرتني أعمى وقد كنت بصيرا قال كذلك أتتك آياتنا فنسيتها وكذلك اليوم تنسى وقال تعالى في مقام آخر والذين هم للزكاة فاعلون والذين هم لفروجهم حافظون إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين فمن ابتغى وراء ذلك فأولئك هم العادون وقال النبي صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم لتتبعن سنن من كان قبلكم شبرا بشبر ذراعا بذراع حتى لو دخلوا جحر ضب لاتبعتموهم قالوا اليهود والنصارى يا رسول الله قال فمن وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام ليأتين على أمتي كما أتى على بني إسرائيل حذو النعل بالنعل حتى إن كان منهم من أتى أمه علانية لكان في أمتي من يصنع ذلك وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام يا أبا سفيان جئتكم بخير الدنيا وكرامة الآخرة أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام صدق الله المولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين That is why Ibn Kathir رحمه الله has written Get your daughter married to a muttaqi In ahabbaha akramaha If he loves her there will be mutual agreement and understanding However, if he dislikes her, his taqwa won't allow him to oppress her. If he dislikes her and there's problems, then it is bound to happen. Like one brother said, Maulana, marriage is like the weather. Sometimes it's hot and next minute there's clouds. Sometimes it's raining for 1 week, but the sun comes out. But you have to bear it patiently. In ahabbaha akramaha, if he has muhabbat, they will live with understanding. But if there's misunderstanding and there's difficulties and there's ups and downs, his taqwa won't allow him to oppress that girl. Why? Because he fears Allah. And this is what the Nabi of Allah has asked Allah. Allahumma qsim lana min khashyatik ma tahulu bihi baynana wa bayna ma'asiyatik. Oh Allah, we ask you, give us that amount of your fear which becomes an obstacle in disobeying you. You tell a man, boy, yeah, there's someone has offered wine. He says, no, I'm a Muslim. He has that amount of iman which will not allow him to even entertain the thought of consuming wine. But now when it comes to business and he is lying in his business, his iman is not of that level to prevent him from lies. So, oh Allah, give us that amount of taqwa and we also make it now, say ameen brothers. Oh Allah, give us that amount of taqwa that becomes an obstacle in your disobedience. When that woman delivers that child and she comes back, The Nabi of Allah, who did not oppress the animal kingdom, where is he going to oppress this child? وَعَلَى الْوَالِدَاتُ يُرْضِعْنَ أَوْلَادَهُنَّ حَوْلَيْنِ كَامِلَيْنِ لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَن يُتِمَّ الرَّضَاعَ Take this child and do not deprive this masoom child of the nutrition that the mother, that Allah has kept in the milk of the mother. أَدَرْتُ لَكَ عِرْقَيْنِ رَقِيقَيْنِ يُنْبِعَانِ لَكَ لَبَنًا خَالِصًا دَافِعًا فِي الشِّتَاءِ وَبَارِدًا فِي الصَّيْفِ That provisions that Allah has made on the chest of the mother. Wherever Allah Pak tested insan, when he had to leave the dunya, the form of sustenance was through the navel. Allah Pak made him leave the womb of his mother, and Allah Pak closed one door, and Allah Pak opened two avenues on the chest of his mother. When the period of suckling the child had terminated, And now the mother was not to suckle the child. Allah closed the two avenues and Allah opened the four doors of this dunya that now don't restrict this child to milk and cereal. Now you can give him biryani and you can give him whatever you want to. And when it was time to leave this dunya, it became difficult for him to pass with the four avenues that Allah had opened. So Allah said, make sabr on this and the eight doors of Jannah are open for you. This woman, after she suckles her child, she comes back to the Nabi of Allah according to the riwayat of Muslim Sharif. where the child is eating solid. And the Nabi of Allah says, now carry out the command of Allah. And in the process, when Rajam was taking place and she was being pelted, she passes away. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, now give her ghusl and kafan. And the janazah was brought. The sifts were formed. The Nabi of Allah was about to say, Allahu Akbar. When Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu taps him on his shoulder and says, Tusalli alayha ya Rasulallah wa qad zanat. O Nabi of Allah, you are the cream of Allah's creation. And this is an adulteress. Are you such a pak makhluk of Allah going to lead the janazah of this woman? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, O Umar, don't judge this woman on the wrong that she has done. Wallah, judge her on the tawbah that she has made. Wallahi laqad tabat tawbatan law qusimat bayna sab'een min ahli al-madina. She has made such a tawbah. And Allah is so pleased that on her tawbah at this moment, 70 people's maghfirat can be made. Allah out of His divine knowledge said that zina is haram. Man felt that Allah was interfering. Allah said that gambling is haram. Maulana brought it to our notice. What is the condition of our children? And look at the advertisement, the board advertising, you are 5 minutes away to the next casino by limousine, 2 minutes only. That means, come on, how can you miss it? You're so close. The Quran says, إِنَّمَا الْخَمْرُ وَالْمَيْسِرُ وَالْأَنْصَابُ وَالْأَزْلَامُ رِجْسٌ مِنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ فَاجْتَنِبُوهُ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. Allah says, consuming of wine and gambling is all forms of vice, evil, violation, impurity. فَجِتَنِبُوهُ, abstain from it so that you can be successful. Man with his ignorance and arrogance says that we have invented the lottery so that we can help people. Do it and gamble so that you can be successful. The Quran is saying abstain so that you can be successful. Brothers, today the entire dunya is at war with Allah. Our thinking has shifted not away from Quran and Hadith, but it has come onto the direct opposite of Quran and Hadith. The Quran says, وَلَكُمْ فِي الْقِصَاصِ حَيَاةٌ يَا أُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. That when a person's life has been taken in exchange of his life, وَكَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِيهَا أَنَّ النَّفْسَ بِالنَّفْسِ وَالْعَيْنَ بِالْعَيْنِ one for one, الْحُرُّ بِالْحُرِّ وَالْعَبْدُ بِالْعَبْدِ. A person's life will be taken. Allah says, one for one, by carrying out this command of Allah and establishing this death penalty, you will be preserving and protecting your life. And Allah addresses insan at that time, Ya ulil albab, O people of intelligence, I'm sure you can understand this. What Allah Pak has addressed as the protecting and preserving of our lives. And Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Iqamatu haddim min hududillah. Iqamatu haddim min hududillah. Khayrun min matari arba'een sabahan fi biladillah. O kama qal. Establishing of this command, there are four hudud. One is when a person has committed zina. One is when a person has consumed wine. One is when a person is guilty of accusing someone of zina. وَالَّذِينَ يَرْمُونَ الْمُحْصَنَاتِ, where the Quran makes mention of accusing innocent, chaste women of zina. According to one riwayat of Tibrani, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, قَذْفُ الْمُحْصَنَاتِ يهدم عمل مئة سنة أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. That accusing a chaste woman of zina will destroy the piety of 100 years. And when a person is guilty of stealing, this is referred to as hudud, where the divine penalty has been decided by Allah. And with regards to the other ahkam, we have ta'zirat, where it has been handed over to the qazi, the Muslim judge. Whatever is suitable according to the situation, he will carry out respectively. However, the Nabi of Allah says, establishing this command, where if a person is guilty of zina, to pelt him or to lash him, is more beneficial for that country than 40 days of beneficial rain. Now what the Nabi of Allah is terming as more beneficial than 40 days of rain, today's arrogant man doesn't acknowledge it as beneficial, but rather challenges it and says it's barbaric. Can we imagine, respected brothers and elders, how we have shifted? Our whole thinking has shifted away from the divine guidance of Allah and Allah's Nabi. Allah Pak makes mention in the Quran of that person. One day I was sitting and Allah Pak put this in my mind. Allah speaks about that person whom man terms as lucky and fortunate. And then Allah Pak speaks about that person whom Allah terms as lucky and fortunate. And Allah uses the same description. Allah speaks about Qarun. When Qarun was walking with his people, فخرج على قومه في زينته قال الذين يريدون الحياة الدنيا قال الذين يريدون الحياة الدنيا يا ليت لنا مثل ما أوتي قارون. With him he had his wealth and his servants, and it was very striking to the eye. The Quran says, those who were desirous of the world, which the Nabi of Allah said, يأتي على الناس الزمان, the riwayat is in Kanz al-Ummal, a time is to dawn upon insan, himamuhum butunuhum, sharafuhum mata'uhum, qiblatuhum nisa'uhum, deenuhum darahimuhum wa dananiruhum, ulaika shirarul khalq la khalaq lahum indallah. A time is to come where a man's entire thinking, ability, capacity, health, wealth, strength will only be focused in how I can fill my belly with the best of this dunya. Whether it means or it demands I must snatch the rights of orphans. إِنَّمَا يَأْكُلُونَ فِي بُطُونِهِمْ نَارًا. Allah says, you are not eating that man's rights, you are filling your stomach with the fire of Jahannam. The choice is how much you want to fill your belly. لقمان عليه السلام told his son, يَا بُنَيَّ لِيَكُنْ جَرَاءَتُكَ عَلَى الْمَعَاصِي بِقَدْرِ صَبْرِكَ عَلَى النَّارِ. Have that amount of guts and courage in violating the commands of Allah, how much tolerance you have in accepting and persevering the punishment of Allah. According to that you can do. Himamuhum butunuhum, sharafuhum mata'uhum. Their honor will revolve around the material progress. Qiblatuhum nisa'uhum, the sense of direction will be the woman. Deenuhum darahimuhum wa dananiruhum, their religion will be their wealth. Dollar jalla jalaluhu rain amma nawaluhu. Ulaika shirarul khalqi la khalaqa lahum indallah. This is the worth of Allah's creation. What was the thinking of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Nabi alayhi salam's thinking for the entire ummah was, man asbaha minkum mu'afan fi jasadihi, آمِنًا فِي سِرْبِهِ عِنْدَهُ قُوتُ يَوْمِهِ فَكَأَنَّمَا حُيِّزَتْ لَهُ الدُّنْيَا بِحَذَافِيرِهَا أَيْ جُمِعَتْ لَهُ بِتَمَامِهَا. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if you got up in the morning, you are healthy, you have shelter above you. Imam Qurtubi rahmatullah alayhi says, what is shelter? كُلُّ مَا عَلَاكَ فَأَضَلَّكَ فَهُوَ سَقْفٌ وَكُلُّ مَا أَقَلَّكَ فَهُوَ أَرْضٌ وكل ما سترك من جهاتك الأربع فهو جدار فإذا اتصلت وانتظمت فهو بيت. Whatever covers you from the top is a roof, whatever you're standing on is the ground, and whatever covers you from four sides is a wall. When these three things are put together, it is a house. You got up, you are healthy, you have shelter above you, and Nabi alayhi salam says you have food to take you across the day. It's the words of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَكَأَنَّمَا حُيِّزَتْ لَهُ الدُّنْيَا بِحَذَافِيرِهَا. Wallah, it is as though Allah Pak has exclusively given you alone all the good of this entire dunya. Now if we can get up with that frame of mind and open our shop, keeping that as our limit. In fact, there won't be need for us to perhaps open our shop for a few months. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam enters into the garden of one sahabi and he takes a date and he starts eating. And Ibn Umar is what? So he tells him, مَا لَكَ يَبْنَ عُمَرْ لَا تَأْكُلْ. Oh, Ibn Umar, join me. He says, لَا أَشْتَهِي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Oh, Nabi of Allah, I do not desire dates. Nabi alayhi salam says, oh, Ibn Umar, for me it is not a question of desiring or not. 4 days have left, wallah, nothing has entered the stomach. Maulana was speaking about the beauty of Nabi alayhi salam. Two couplets came to my mind. One is where the poet says, شَهِدَ الْأَنَامُ بِفَضْلِهِ حَتَّى الْعِدَى وَالْفَضْلُ مَا شَهِدَتْ بِهِ الْأَعْدَاءُ. Allahu Akbar. شَهِدَ الْأَنَامُ بِفَضْلِهِ حَتَّى الْعِدَى وَالْفَضْلُ مَا شَهِدَتْ بِهِ الْأَعْدَاءُ. That the entire creation was compelled to acknowledge the excellence of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the extent even the enemy of Nabi alayhi salam, as bitter as it was for him, he had to accept and acknowledge the excellence of Nabi alayhi salam. Then the poet says, the beauty of a man is not what his friend accepts, what his enemy accepts. That is the beauty of a man. What my wife says and what my children say about me, that's not my beauty. What my enemy accepts and is compelled to accept, that is the beauty. وَالْفَضْلُ مَا شَهِدَتْ بِهِ الْأَعْدَاءُ. And the poet says, after compiling couplets on the shan of Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, مَا إِمْ مَدَحْتُ مُحَمَّدًا بِمَقَالَتِي وَلَكِمْ مَدَحْتُ مَقَالَتِي بِمُحَمَّدِي. He writes a poem on the beauty of Nabi alayhi salam. Then he says, O Nabi of Allah, wallah, it is not your fortune or your good fortune that I have compiled a poem regarding your beauty. But I must thank Allah that I am lucky to have your name in my poem. It's my luck that I have your name in my poem. Allah has praised you. So praising you is not honoring you. The man who has the opportunity to praise you, it's his honor. That man whose tongue is being used for the introduction of Allah, which is the object of every ummati, وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ. It is our luck. And we are lucky if Allah uses our tongue to introduce Allah to the creation. Allah is introduced. Allah, everybody knows, أَذْهَرْ مِنَ الشَّمْسِ. But if Allah uses my broken, napak tongue, then I'm lucky. Allah doesn't need introduction. He speaks, his whole Quran is, سَبَّحَ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Allah says, what you see, what you can't see, what you fathom, what you cannot fathom, what has life in it, what is inanimate, everything praises me. وَالَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ فَمِنْكُمْ كَافِرٌ وَمِنْكُمْ مُؤْمِنٌ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. He has created you, he has designed you. صَوَّرَكُمْ فَأَحْسَنَ صُوَرَكُمْ وَإِلَيْهِ الْمَصِيرُ. Allah has designed you, fashioned you, as he so wished. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, that person who gets up in the morning in that condition, it is as though the good of the entire dunya has been given to him. So Qarun is walking. Those that are desirous of the dunya are looking at him. And what they are saying, يَا لَيْتَ لَنَا مِثْلَ مَا أُوتِيَ قَارُونُ إِنَّهُ لَذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ. How we wish if we also had the wealth of this man. Now, the words that I want we must ponder and contemplate over is, they refer to Qarun as by saying, إِنَّهُ verily he, لَذُو the possessor, حَظٍ شَيْءٍ عَظِيمٍ great. Verily he is the possessor of a great share. Allah uses these very same words, that he is the possessor of a great share, but not for Qarun, for someone else. And then Allah speaks, how does the believer react? وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ وَيْلَكُمْ ثَوَابُ اللَّهِ وَيْلَكُمْ ثَوَابُ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لِّمَنْ آمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. Those that had the knowledge of deen, Allah give us that through ilm, which Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ عِلْمًا أَن يَخْشَى اللَّهِ. If a man has the fear of Allah, then that is sufficient knowledge. كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ عِلْمًا أَن يَخْشَى اللَّهِ. And if a man disobeys Allah, then that is sufficient ignorance. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu used to say, النَّاسُ مِنْ جِهَةِ التَّمْثِيلِ أَنْكَاءُ أَبُوهُمْ آدَمُ وَالْأُمُّ حَوَّاءُ نَفْسٌ كَنَفْسٍ وَأَرْوَاحٌ مُشَاكَلَةٌ وَأَعْظَمٌ خُلِقَتْ فِيهِمْ وَأَعْضَاءُ فَإِنْ يَكُنْ لَهُمْ مِنْ أَصْلِهِمْ حَسَبٌ يُفَاخِرُونَ بِهِ فَالطِّينُ وَالْمَاءُ مَا الْفَضْلُ إِلَّا لِأَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ إِنَّهُمْ عَلَى الْهُدَى لِمَنْ اسْتَهْدَى أَدِلَّاءُ وَقَدْرُ كُلُّ امْرِئٍ مَا كَانَ يُحْسِنُهُ وَلِلرِّجَالِ عَلَى الْأَفْعَالِ أَسْمَاءُ. سيدنا علي رضي الله عنه used to say, insan from the human point of view are all equal. الناس من جهة التمثيل أنكاء أبوهم آدم والأم حواء. The father bin Adam عليه السلام and the mother bin Hawa عليه السلام. نفس كنفس. We all have نفس. وأرواحهم مشاكلة. And everyone's روح is the same. وأعظم خلقت فيهم وأعظى bones, flesh, etc. فإن يكن لهم من أصلهم حسب. If there is anybody who wants to boast among this insan and wants to brag about anything of what he owns, then Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu says, tell him, فالطين والماء. You started from dirty water. And look at the system of Allah. One day I was mentioning in madrasa to the students that Allah Pak commenced the journey of insan from filthy flute. And then Allah made the form of nourishment for that filthy flute something which was more napak or equally napak, and that was the blood that comes out of that woman. Allah used two such impurities which are so napak that makes ghusl compulsory, and from that Allah created the cream of his creation. Man, if he wants to make something tasty, on a small scale, if a woman wants to prepare a delicious meal, she wants to make biryani, she has to use valuable and expensive ingredients. Saffron is going to be used. Man, number one, cannot create. But even if he wants to design something beautiful, he needs valuable ingredients. Allah uses such napak ingredients. And Allah says, وَلَقَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ فِي أَحْسَنِ التَّقْوِيمِ. We design man in the best of appearances. Allah's Qudrat. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu says, if anybody has honor, it is the one that has the knowledge of deen. These are those that are honored. How does those that have ilm reacted? وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْعِلْمَ وَيْلَكُمْ ثَوَابُ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ لِمَنْ آمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. Those that have the knowledge of deen said, woe be to you. A believer is one who focuses on akhirat. The life of a kafir, Allah has summed up in one verse, which is the greatest fitna. Allah Pak speaks, what is the life of a kafir? One verse. The Quran in its jami'iyya, as concise as it is, volumes can be written on this one verse of the Quran. أَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهَهُ هَوَى. O Nabi of Allah, that kafir obeys his nafs and obeys his evil as Allah ought to be obeyed. That is why when it comes to the evil and the wrong that today the West are promoting is not only violating the laws of Allah, but wallah is violating the laws of nature. We spoke about zina, that is not all. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the Quran says they have made their nafs their ilah. And the nafs only takes towards evil. If the nafs demands zina, they will fornicate. If the nafs demands gambling, they will gamble. If the nafs demands consuming wine, they will consume. There is no barrier. The nafs only demands evil. And the Quran says they obey their nafs as I, that is Allah, was supposed to be obeyed. The Nabi of Allah tells us of something that is more worrying. لَيَأْتِيَنَّ عَلَىٰ أُمَّتِي كَمَا أَتَىٰ عَلَىٰ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ حَذْوَ النَّعْلِ بِالنَّعْلِ. Following of nafs. What is the end? Where is it going to lead a man to? The riwayat of Tirmizi Sharif, second volume, Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, all the fitnas that came on Bani Israel is going to come upon this ummah. Be it the ummah da'wat or the ummah ijabat. Hatta in kana minhum man ata ummahu alaniya, lakana fi ummati man yasna'u dhalik. To the extent, what we're talking of incest today, zina bil maharim. If a man in the previous nations slept with his mother, wallah, in my ummah, people will share the bed with their own mothers. And the riwayat of Muslim Sharif, لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سُنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ شِبْرًا بِشِبْرٍ ذِرَاعًا بِذِرَاعٍ. You will follow the nations that preceded you, inch by inch, step by step. حتى لو دخلوا جحر ضب لاتبعتموهم. To the extent that if they entered the hole of a lizard, which is apparently contradicting with every form of logic, but because they did it, لاتبعتموهم, knowing not why they went in that hole, because they did it, you'll also join and you'll also enter the hole. Sahaba Ikram said, قالوا اليهود والنصارى يا رسول الله. O Nabi of Allah, when you are saying the nations that preceded us, do you refer to the Yahud and the Nasara? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قَالَ فَمَنْ If not them, then who else?
أَوْحَى اللَّهُ إِلَىٰ نَبِيٍ مِّنَ الْأَنْبِيَاءِ أَنْ قُلْ لِقَوْمِكَ لَا تَدْخُلُوا مَدَاخِلَ أَعْدَائِي وَلَا يَرْكَبُوا مَرَاكِبَ أَعْدَائِي وَلَا يَلْبَسُوا مَلَابِسَ أَعْدَائِي وَلَا يَطْعَمُوا مَطَائِمَ أَعْدَائِي فَيَكُونُوا أَعْدَائِي كَمَا هُمْ أَعْدَائِي. Allah send revelation on the Nabi. Tell your nation not to dress like my enemies, not to conduct their lives like my enemies, not to make their homes like my enemies. If they're going to resemble them like that and eat like them, love like them, dress like them, then the chances are just as they are my enemies, you also will become my enemy. Our thinking has shifted. The point that I'm driving home today is, brothers and sisters, we have to bring our understanding in total accordance to the divine commands of Allah. If a person will shift it and his logic contrary to that of the commands of Allah and Allah's Rasul, a father in his house will pay the consequences, a teacher in his school will pay it, a president in his country will pay it, and the entire dunya, if they will shift, they will pay the price. Whoever, in whatever form, will come onto the pattern of Nabi alayhi salam, Allah will show him the guidance and the doors of hidayat opening in this dunya. The Nabi of Allah, what has he defined as a good home? And what have you and I defined as a good home? A house where there is best of furniture, where the blinds and the tiles are matching, where everything is striking. The Nabi of Allah says, خَيْرُ بَيْتِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ بَيْتٌ فِيهِ يَتِيمٌ يُحْسَنُ إِلَيْهِ. The riwayat of Ibn Majah, the best Muslim house is that house wherein there is one orphan who eats there every day. That house which has an orphan, be it a hut or be it a palace, the Nabi of Allah, the وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى, the words of Allah, the Nabi of Allah says there is no better home on the face of this earth than that house. One person comes to Nabi alayhi salam, شَكَى رَجُلٌ إِلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ قَصْوَةَ قَلْبِهِ. O Nabi of Allah, my heart is gone very hard. I listen to the talks of Allah and Allah's Rasul, but it does not impress on me. Nabi alayhi salam says, إِمْسَحْ رَأْسَ الْيَتِيمِ. O my Sahabi, it looks like you are not taking care of the orphans. Bring the orphans close to you. إِنَّ لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ مِفْتَاحٌ وَمِفْتَاحُ الْجَنَّةِ حُبُّ الْمَسَاكِينِ. Every door has a key. The key of Jannah is the love of the poor. Sahaba Ikram, Nabi alayhi salam gave a bayan. Everybody started crying. Zaid radiallahu anhu could not cry. I always mention, in the time of Nabi alayhi salam, the one that could not cry felt odd. Allah forgive, in our situation, the one that cries is odd. In the time of Nabi alayhi salam, the person that couldn't cry was odd. O Nabi of Allah, I don't know, I cannot cry. I'm deprived. Today a man is deprived of crying before Allah. And he does not feel he is deprived, which wallah is more serious than being deprived. A man cannot cry, he doesn't feel he lacks anything. And yet, that very same man has such attachment to dunya, one pair of his shoes can get stolen in the masjid, he will cry in such a way that people will have to knock his door and console him. But that the very same man, himself, his wife and his children, haven't seen namaz for the last 20 years, not one day there was any form of sorrow on his face. Nabi alayhi salam says, قَصْوَةُ الْقَلْبِ جمود العين من قسوة القلب وقسوة القلب من كثرة الذنوب وكثرة الذنوب من نسيان الموت ونسيان الموت من طول الأمل وطول الأمل من حب الدنيا وحب الدنيا رأس كل خطيئة. جمود العين, the lack of tears is because of a hard-heartedness. وقسوة القلب and hard-heartedness is because of excessive sinning. وَكَثْرَةُ الذُّنُوبِ مِنْ نِسْيَانِ الْمَوْتِ. An excessive sinning is because of unawareness of death. And unawareness of death only comes when a man becomes ambitious in this world. And a man only becomes ambitious when he loves this dunya, and when he loves it, it is the root of every evil. What the Nabi of Allah has termed as poison, we have termed as medication. How can we ever earn the pleasure of Allah? How can the ummah prosper, which the Nabi of Allah has termed as poison, you and I are terming it as medication. What he's saying we must run from, we are bringing it closer to us. Coming back to that incident of Qarun, this is what the Quran says, that's how the believer reacts. And the next day Allah Pak showed them that Qarun was walking
He refused to pay his zakat. He was very knowledgeable with reference to the riwayat of Jalalain. He had iman. كَانَ أَعْلَمُ النَّاسِ بِالتَّوْرَاةِ بَعْدَ مُوسَى وَهَارُونَ. He was the most knowledgeable man of the Torah after Musa and Harun alayhi salam. Allah blessed them with nabuwat. Allah did not give him, make him a nabi. He was the cousin of Musa alayhi salam according to the riwayat of Jalalain, which led to jealousy and then led to kufr. Allah told Musa alayhi salam, O Musa, the land is at your command. فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. He was walking with those very same people. Musa alayhi salam ordered the earth to split. Those very same people who were extending an envious eye at this man yesterday, today with his wealth, with his honor, they seen him sinking into the earth. فَمَا كَانَ لَهُ مِنْ فِئَةٍ يَنْصُرُونَهُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ وَمَا كَانَ مِنَ الْمُنْتَصِرِينَ. At that time it became evident. هُنَالِكَ الْوَلَايَةُ أي هُنَالِكَ عُلِمَ أَنَّ الْوَلَايَةَ لِلَّهِ. It became evident that the control is only of Allah. And nobody can assist and divert and avert the decision that Allah has sent. Now who does Allah term as lucky? The very same words that Allah has used, what these kuffar said for Qarun, Allah uses it for who He says is lucky. Allah makes mention in the Quran, وَلَا تَسْتَوِي الْحَسَنَةُ وَلَا السَّيِّئَةِ ادْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنِ فَإِذَا الَّذِي بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَهُ عَدَاوَةٌ كَأَنَّهُ وَلِيٌّ حَمِيمٌ. That answer rudeness was kindness, hatred with love. This was the general hukum of the Quran. وَإِنْ عَاقَبْتُمْ فَعَاقِبُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا عُوقِبْتُمْ بِهِ. If someone hurts you, you can hurt him equivalent to how much harm was caused to you. But وَلَئِنْ صَبَرْتُمْ لَهُوَ خَيْرٌ لِلصَّابِرِينَ. If you make sabr, it is better. And with regards to the Nabi of Allah, there is no option. وَاسْبِرْ وَمَا صَبْرُكَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. Your akhlaq demands nothing but sabr. اِدْفَعْ بِالَّتِي هِيَ أَحْسَنُ السَّيِّئَةِ نَحْنُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يَصِفُونَ. O Nabi of Allah, you only answer their rudeness with kindness, patience and tolerance. We know, نَحْنُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا يَصِفُونَ. We know exactly what they are saying. فَمَنْ عَفَى وَأَصْلَحَ فَأَجْرُهُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Whoever forgives and overlooks, like they say, Allah gives and forgives, man gets and forgets. Allah gives and forgives, man gets and he forgets. The one that will forgive, Allah Pak will forgive him. One person spoke ill of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is standing there and he's speaking, he's criticizing. Abu Bakr is silent, Nabi alayhi salam is silent. Again he passed an evil remark, again Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu is silent. On the third instance when he passed an evil remark, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, it is but correct, the Quran has given me the authority to speak back, and he spoke back. When he spoke back, the Nabi of Allah stood up and he walked away. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, O Nabi of Allah, this man spoke bad of me, I kept silent on two occasions. On the third time, I felt it was just but correct that I answer, and I respond to his criticism, and when I did so, you stood up and you walked away. Nabi alayhi salam said, O Abu Bakr, when you were silent, Jibreel was speaking. You started speaking, Jibreel went away, I also had to go. If you are quiet, Allah will handle it. أَنَا مَلِكُ الْمُلُوكِ وَقُلُوبُ الْمُلُوكِ بِيَدِهِ. I am the king of kings, and the heart of every king is in my hand. فَلَا تَشْغَلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ بِالدُّعَاءِ عَلَى الْمُلُوكِ. Don't be foolish to curse him, because he's there because of your amal. Sort your amal out and I'll put the right man there. Change your approach and I'll put the right man there. Allah says, this type of akhlaq, that is answering rudeness with kindness, hatred with love, ignorance with tolerance. وَلَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَمَا يُلَقَّاهَا إِلَّا ذُو حَظٍ عَظِيمٍ. The one who develops this type of akhlaq, that can fill مَنْ قَطَعَكَ أُعْفُ عَمْ مَنْ ظَلَمَكَ أَحْسِنْ إِلَى مَنْ أَسَاءَ إِلَيْكَ. That can humble his pride and give up all the politics that exist in families that have broken our families into bits and pieces, and can humble himself for the pleasure of Allah and go and meet his Muslim brother. Allah says, the one that has that akhlaq, in my eyes, he is the lucky one. Allah uses the exact description which those kuffar used for the wealth of Qarun. How you are looking at him to be lucky, Allah says, in my eyes, the one that has that akhlaq
which you and I say, Kibai, this poor guy is forever, he can't speak anything, he's always defeated, he's always overpowered, he never retaliates. In the eyes of Allah, this is that lucky one. Allah bless us with that akhlaq. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, as I was mentioning in the beginning, that as we are desirous of a good life, Allah has the very same desire for us. And Allah desires it in this world, qabr and akhirat. And on the tongue of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah has explained it. Ya Mu'az, in aratta aisha al-su'ada, wa meetata al-shuhada, wa al-najata yawm al-hashri, wa al-amn yawm al-khawfi, wa al-nur yawm al-zulumat, wa al-zill yawm al-harur, wa al-riya yawm al-ash, wa al-huda yawm al-zalala, فادرس القرآن فإنه ذكر الرحمن فإنه ذكر الرحمن وحرز من الشيطان ورجحان في الميزان. O Mu'adh, if you want a happy life in this world, a blissful life, a life with peace and understanding, the ayat al-kareema that I recited in the beginning, today the greatest Baitani that has not left anyone, which is the cause of deviation from the command of Allah. The ayat al-kareem I recited, Allah says, the one that will obey Allah and do good, Allah promises him a good life. The commentators in great detail have discussed this ayat. What is meant by a good life? If we study the life of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and that of Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam, then we'll find those two qualities which you and I term as a good life were not found in majority of them, health and wealth. You and I would term that as a prosperous life, health and wealth. Now the Quran says whoever obeys Allah will have a good life. If we study the lives of Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, majority of them went through the life of poverty. That makes us understand that a good life necessarily does not have to mean a wealthy life. The Nabi of Allah's poverty was optional. The other day I gave one bayan and I spoke on this only on this one point, that the Nabi of Allah's poverty was optional and the wisdom in opting for poverty. Why? He was not told that if you are given wealth, you won't be a Nabi. He was told, in shi'ta nabiyyan malika wa in shi'ta nabiyyan abda. We will give you an empire and a kingdom and we'll make you a Nabi. Or we'll keep you poor and make you a Nabi. So inevitably, nabuwat is your share. However, the choice is yours. You want it with wealth or without wealth. Yet he said he wants it with poverty. Why? Whereas he was told that with it will come your nabuwat. Be it, even if you are given the empire of this dunya, you still will be the Nabi of Allah. And not only for himself, for his children. Allahumma ja'al rizqa ali Muhammadin quta. Oh Allah, don't give my children above their need. Don't give them more than what they need. So much that they can love. مَا قَلَّ وَكَفَى خَيْرٌ مِمَّا كَثُرَ وَأَلْهَى. Keep them how much they got and they can love and survive, it's enough. Not above that, oh Allah. What was the wisdom of this? When Musa alayhi salatu wa salam was sent to Fir'aun and he refused the message, then Musa alayhi salam told Allah, ربنا إنك آتيت فرعون وملأه زينة وأموالا في الحياة الدنيا ربنا ليضلوا عن سبيلك ربنا تمس على أموالهم واشدد على قلوبهم فلا يؤمنوا حتى يروا العذاب الأليم. Oh Allah, you have given this man too much money. Till you will not convert his wealth into poverty and his health into sickness, he will never rub his forehead before you. Ya Allah, take that wealth away. Ya Allah, take that health away. And I am promising he will accept your oneness. And the Quran testifies, حَتَّى إِذَا أَدْرَكَهُ الْغَرَقُ قَالَ آمَنْتُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا الَّذِي آمَنَتْ بِهِ بَنُو إِسْرَائِيلِ وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. When drowning overpowered Pharaoh, he said, I accept none reserved or none has the right to be worshipped other than Allah. And he said, oh Allah, when that azab will come, he will bring iman.
There was wisdom in what the Nabi of Allah had asked Allah. So, if we study the life of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, it was a life of poverty. That makes us understand that wealth is not a good life. It could come also, but it doesn't necessarily have to come. Wealth is not the factor that will determine a good life. Then the second factor is that of health. If we study the lives of the Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam, the hadith says, أَشَدُّ النَّاسِ بَلَاءً الْأَنْبِيَا. The people that were tested by Allah the most were the prophets. Take the life of Ayyub alayhi salam, which the Quran says, نِعْمَ الْعَبْدُ إِنَّهُ أَوَّابُ. The best servant. And Allah says, ni'mah. Ni'mah is used as a verb of praise, of alim madah. What a nice person is an Ayyub. One is I say, one is you say. Ya Allah is saying, what a nice person is an Ayyub. Innahu awwab, he always turns to me. How Allah tested him with sickness. Wa Ayyuba idh nada rabbahu anni massani adh-dhurru wa anta arhamur rahimin. فاستجبنا له فكشفنا ما به من ضر وآتيناه أهله ومثلهم معهم رحمة من عندنا وذكرى للعابدين. He had 14 children. Allah took all his children away. He had business. This is according to authentic narrations. I'm not going into Israeliyat. Allah took his children away. He had businesses. Allah took his business. He lost his house. And his health was going from bad to worse. He had to stay outside because of the flesh falling out from his skin. His wife used to serve him. One day his wife told him, oh, you make dua to Allah. 7 years of your sickness have left. Make dua to Allah that Allah must now decide your cure. Ayyub alayhi salatu was salam said, in the Hashia of Jalalain, this is mentioned, ma balagat muddatu musibati muddatu rakhai. My years of difficulty has not reached the years of ease and prosperity. Allah gave me 80 years of ease and prosperity, and Allah has only tested me with 8 years. When Allah tests me after 80 years, then I feel I reserve the right to ask Allah. But I think it's only fair that when 80 years I ate from Him, now when He tests me, at least 80 years let me beg patiently. After that, I'll open my mouth. And how does he make dua to Allah? Rabbi Massani Yadhur. Wallah, I have been afflicted with difficulty. Wa anta arhamur rahimin, and you are the most kind. I'm not going to say take the sickness away because it's from you and it is a form of ni'mat, although a disguised form in our understanding because we can't see the wisdom, we cannot understand it. Wallah, I am sick and you know that. You are the most kind. Allah removed that sickness and Allah gave him shifa and Allah gave life to all the children. وَآتَيْنَاهُ أَهْلَهُ وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ. And then Allah gave him another 14 children according to the riwayat of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. So sickness came on Anbiya alayhi salatu wasalam. That makes us understand that a good life doesn't have to mean a healthy life. The question is that what is a good life? If a good life is not a wealthy life and a good life is not a healthy life, then Mawlana, what is a good life? This is it, brothers. We don't know what we're heading for. We don't know what we want. This sent Baitani in the Ummah. The ulama has mentioned two qualities which would determine a good life. Number one, the first quality, that this is a man who has been blessed and endowed with a good life, Allah Pak will give him contentment. Be it in health or sickness, be it in wealth or poverty, he will be happy on the condition that Allah has decided for him. And this is a quality which by me verbally uttering and you listening, neither I can achieve it, neither you can achieve it, neither we can purchase it, neither can someone sell it. Divinely Allah inspires it and divinely Allah snatches it. So as much as we know, one point I wanted to mention, which Maulana was making mention of the fitna of Dajjal, my Ustaz Maulana Sulaiman Choksi Damat Barakatuh used to mention that many a time Shaitan injects this evil thought in our mind that the Nabi of Allah has described the Dajjal by saying إِنَّهُ أَعْوَرْ وَإِنَّ رَبَّكُمْ لَيْسَ بِأَعْوَرْ, that he is one-eyed, and remember Allah is not one-eyed. مَعْهُ نَارٌ وَنَهْرٌ, he will have hell and paradise with him. He will tour the entire dunya in 40 days. يَوْمٌ كَسَنَةٍ وَيَوْمٌ كَشَهْرٍ, one day equivalent to a year, one day equivalent to a month, and one day equivalent to a week, and the 37 days equivalent to the 24 hours of a day. So many a time Shaitan makes us feel that when the Nabi of Allah has described Dajjal in so much detail, we won't miss him when we see him. We'll make him out. But you are Dajjal. The Nabi of Allah told us, you one eye, one day went so long, this is what you got. It's evident you're Dajjal. Allah must keep us away. And we rely that we will be protected from this fitna of Dajjal on the basis and on the grounds of the knowledge that we have regarding him. Maustad used to say, Allah ki kasam, is dhoke se nikal jao. Kisko pata nahi ki is zamana ka fitna maal hai, lekin kaun bachta hai? Who doesn't know that the fitna of this time is wealth, and who is abstaining from it because of having the knowledge? Who doesn't know that the Nabi of Allah said, ma taraktu ba'di fitna adarru ala rijal min al-nisa. I have not left behind a greater challenge for the males of my ummah than the fitna of women. Who doesn't know this hadith of Nabi alayhi salam? But who has been protected from this fitna because of having the knowledge? So this is a deception. It's a delusion from the devil. Maulana Muhammad Ilyas rahmatullah alayhi used to say, Aray iman walo, iman ke dhoke se nikal jao. Allah ki kasam, jo tum iman samajhte ho, wallah iman nahi hai. Oh, the people of faith, come out of the deception of iman. What you are regarding as iman is wallah not iman. A man is standing at the train, on the platform, he's sitting in his train, and another train passes by. When that train is moving, you feel you are also moving. Only when the train has moved, then you realize that, no, I am stationed. Likewise, brothers, now we all think we are moving. When we go in the grave, we'll know how much we moved. That's the time we know, we will know how much we have. فَسَوْفَ تَرَى إِذًا كَسَفَ الْغُبَارِ أَفَرَسٌ تَحْتَ رِجْلِكَ أَمْ حِمَارِ. Allah forgive, every man is content with his amal. A man not reading Fajr, Mawlana, maybe I don't read Fajr, but Alhamdulillah, ma hadha namaz is in the masjid. Maybe I don't read namaz, but one thing my children know, in Ramzan, no TV. Maybe my children don't go madrasa, but wallah, my money, apre rozima to bow chokkas, we are straight. Maybe my business is about corrupt, but my wife knows Saturday night, no outgoing. Each man has taken one command of Allah, comforted himself, consoled himself. Which man is ready to say, never mind my toilet, never mind my kitchen, never mind my lounge, you must see my bedroom. We have taken one aspect of deen, comforted ourselves, consoled ourselves, made the own qiyas, made the jawab of the qiyas, and made the decision of our salvation. Each man is comparing himself to that person who Allah has not made the basis of comparison. He doesn't read namaz, I read namaz. In a poira, they haven't seen namaz. Shukar, my children go for namaz. Look at his wife, Alhamdulillah, my wife doesn't leave the house. Allah didn't say compare with them. Allah says, فَإِنْ آمَنُوا بِمِثْلِ مَا آمَنْتُمْ بِهِ فَقَدِ اهْتَدَوْا. Tell them the wealthy must compare their wealth with Abu Bakr. Tell them the healthy must compare their strength with Khalid. Tell them they must compare their abilities with Bilal. Don't compare with today's Abu Bakr. Compare with the Abu Bakr of the Nabi of Allah. If you can meet his standard, you're in Jannah. If you can't meet him, your abode is something else. We are comparing with whom Allah hasn't made the basis of comparison. Who is the basis of comparison? وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ النَّاسِ. Tell them to bring iman like that of Sahaba. They must compare with Sahaba. Compare your wife, you're comparing it to your neighbor's wife, compare it to the wife of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Compare your wife to the wife of Nabi alayhi salam, who is the daughter of Abu Bakr. You'll compare and compare and give up comparing. There's no comparison. Brothers, when we go down, that's the time we'll realize what has happened and where we have deviated. The Nabi of Allah says, خَيْرُكُمْ خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ وَأَنَا خَيْرُكُمْ لِأَهْلِهِ. The best among you is the one that is the best to his wife, and I am the best to my wife. One day I was sitting and Allah put this thought in my mind. إِنْ كَانَ صَوَابًا فَمِنَ اللَّهِ وَإِنْ كَانَ خَطَأً فَمِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ مِنْهُ بَرِيْئَانِ. That the Nabi of Allah says, the best among you is the one who is the best to his wife. Allah rewards the Nabi of Allah that he practically demonstrated what is meant by kindness to wife. He said he is the best to his wife. And then if we open up the books of hadith and we sit and look at those factors which you and I boast and brag about kindness to our wife. I fill her hands with jewelry. I take her for umrah. I furnish the house. Now if we study those aspects of the Nabi of Allah to his wives, then wallah, what he gave his wives, really we in our foolish understanding will term it as oppression. And the Nabi of Allah says, I am the most kind to my wife. That makes us understand that we don't know what is kindness. The food condition, the riwayat is in Bayhaqi. The hawalas I'm giving, brothers can check reference. Aisha radiallahu anha has two meals. Nabi alayhi salam says, Ya Aisha al-aklu fil yawmi marratayn min al-israf. Wallahu la yuhibbu al-musrifin. Aisha, you eating twice a day, you wasting your life in eating. Allah doesn't like people that are extravagant like this. That's the food attitude he had with Aisha. And he said, nobody has been more kind to anyone's wife as I have been to my wife. What is kindness then? The riwayat is in Mishkat. Aisha radiallahu anha was asked, describe the tahajjud of Nabi alayhi salam. فَلَا تَسْأَلْ عَنْ حُسْنِهِنَّ وَتُولِهِنَّ. Don't even ask me, it's beyond description. However, إِذَا سَجَدَ غَمَزَنِي. When he used to make sajda, with his Mubarak finger, he used to poke me. قَبَلْتُ رِجْلَايَ. I used to pull my feet in. When he used to stand up, I used to go in sajda. The room was so small. The room was so small. Wallah, it could not accommodate the Nabi of Allah making sajda also and me stretching my legs also. I had to pull my legs in and then he made sajda. When he stood up, I pulled my legs in. That was the house. And that was the same quarters he gave to Aisha radiallahu anha. And he says, "Wa ana khayrukum li ahli." There is no one that is more kind to his wife than I am. Brothers, what is kindness? A man gives his wife everything. He hasn't taught her to commence a day with the name of Allah. There was a time when women were giving their children milk, standing and reading the Quran, taking Allah's name, the friends of Allah were born. Allah forgive today's mother is such, today's father is such, in front of the devil books. Saying wrong, looking at wrong, she is giving that masoom child milk. Today, tomorrow, that child grows up to be disobedient. We wonder where it started. The doctors tell us the mother ate something gassy. The child is suffering from colic. How? But the mother ate it. How is the child suffering? Through the medium of milk. That gas travels through the milk. When the gas is going to travel through that milk, oh my mother and oh my sister, won't your tilawat also travel through that milk? Won't your amal travel through that milk when the child is in your stomach and the angel is asking Allah, مُخَلَّقَةٍ أَمْ غَيْرِ مُخَلَّقَةٍ. Oh Allah, must we perfect the creation of the child or must we send the child without eyes? At that crucial moment when the angel is taking the permission of Allah, must this child be given eyes or not? At that time, oh my mother, you are busy looking at haram. If Allah so wanted, He could grudge your child because of your wrong. Lekin qurban ho us Rab ki rahmat par, Allah's kindness and Allah's mercy, He gives that child an equal chance. And He doesn't grudge the child on the wrong of the mother. Allah says, no, give that child and give him beautiful eyes also. Not only eyes, give him beautiful eyes, give him a fair chance. Why deprive that child? Our whole thinking has shifted away from the thinking of Nabi alayhi salam. Brothers, the first quality that will determine and define a good life is that of contentment. يَا بُنَيَّ إِن طَلَبْتَ الْغِنَى فَسْلُبْهُ فِي الْقَنَاعَةِ فَإِنَّهَا مَالٌ لَا يَنْفَدْ. Oh my son, if you want wealth, search for it in contentment, it is unending wealth. Allah says, what is the condition of a kafir? Allah forgive, that is become our condition. Apart from following his base desires, as I mentioned in the beginning, Allah says he is not ready to suppress his evil and accept the truth. Rather, he wants to reverse the situation. وَلَوِ اتَّبَعَ الْحَقُّ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ لَفَسَدَتِ السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ وَمَنْ فِيهِنْ. It is the desire of the evil doers that the haqq and the truth must follow false and batil. They want to reverse the situation. Allah told Nabi alayhi salam, وَلَنْ تَرْضَى عَنْكَ الْيَهُودِ وَلَنْ نَصَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِعَ مِلَّتَهُمْ. Oh my Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Yahud will never be pleased with you until you don't become a Yahud. There's no other way you will impress him. And the Nasara will never and never be happy. The word lan is used, the ulama will tell you, it comes to negate with emphasis in Arabic. وَلَنْ تَرْضَى عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَنْ نَصَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِعَ مِلَّتَهُمْ. Until you don't become a Nasara, he'll never be happy with you. That is the subtle planning of the enemies of Islam. And the irony of the whole thing is, we are accepting it with open arms. We don't question it, we don't... What is being presented to us, we take it as guidance from Allah. And what the Nabi of Allah has brought, we are still trying to debate, should it be done or not. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. That is why, brothers, there is no peace, there is no understanding, there is no muhabbat. The first quality that will define a good life is contentment. One person came to Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani, rahmatullah alayh, and he gave him some money and he said, Hazrat, make dua for me. What dua? Allah must give me more money. Hazrat said, but I'm better than you. I don't have and I don't want. You got and you want more. I don't have and I don't want. Really, I'm happy. I don't want. You got and you want. Allah must give you more. I'm better off, man. Man is so caught up. There's an incident written in one masjid I read. The father comes home tired. The son comes. Abba, can I speak to you? Ji. I'm going to ask you an unusual question today. How much money do you earn per hour? Who are you to ask me? When I'm busy, I got so much things to do. What do you want to know? I'm just asking you. If you feel that I deserve the answer, then tell it to me. Otherwise, no problem. I'll go away. Since seeing you nagging, you're happy, I earn 20 rand an hour. Alright, Abba, second question. I want to ask you, can you give me 10 rand, please? For what you want? You want to buy toys? You want to buy, hey, I can't, I got 100 things to pay and this and that. I haven't got money to waste. Go from here. So the child went away, ate, slept, went away in his bed. After all, the guilt struck the father and he says, after all, it's my son. If I'm not going to give him, who will give him? So he comes to the son and he taps him on the shoulder in the night. He says, Dikra, you sleeping? No, but I'm awake. Make me maaf, ma. I'm feeling so hurt that you asked me and I didn't give you, but here's 10 rand. When the son left the pillow, there was another 10 rand note there. He says, but there you had 10 rand. Why you want another one? He says, Abba, I've got 20 rand now. Tomorrow, I want you to come 1 hour early. I'll pay you for 1 hour, but I want to see your face on the dining table. You're too famous and you're too occupied. The world has you. I don't know when last I had supper with you. I've been saving this money. I want to buy 1 hour from you. Oh, my father, I want to buy 1 hour from you. Can I be lucky enough that before my eyes close, I can sit with you? سَيَذِلُّ عِبْرَةً لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَّكَّرَ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُورًا. This is where the greed of the dunya will take insan. Never mind deen, there won't be time for dunya in our families. The first quality is contentment that will divinely come on the itaat of Allah and nothing else. Brothers, let us get rid of everything that is inviting Allah's wrath. Before our time will come, that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, هَلْ تَنْتَذِرُونَ إِلَّا فَقْرًا مُنْسِيًا أَوْ غِنًا مُتْغِيًا أَوْ هَرَمًا مُفْنِدًا أَوْ مَوْتًا مُجْهِدًا. Allah Pak will bring such sickness on you that even if you want to obey Him, you will be crippled and you will be deprived of prostration before Allah. Stand up and rub your forehead before Allah. Before a time comes that Allah gives you such a sickness, you will be restricted from putting your forehead, which is the izzat of Ibn Adam, to rub this forehead before Allah. Allah will bring such poverty that will make you forget Allah. And the second quality that will determine and define, a good life is that whatever condition comes on a man, Allah will give him the ability to focus on the reward promised by Allah on this condition. So if he's sick, he will look at the reward of akhirat. If he's poor, he will look at the reward of poverty. If he loses his beloved, he will look at the reward. Constantly his gaze will be on ihtisab. Man qama ramadana imanan wa ihtisaba. Man qama ramadana imanan wa ihtisaba. With the total awareness of what Allah has promised for me on this condition. I am fasting, what has Allah kept for me? I have lost my beloved, what has Allah kept for me? I am going through sickness, what has Allah kept for me? I have been tested in my business, what has Allah kept? That person whose focus is on akhirat, constantly, perpetually, this is a sign that Allah Pak has now decided a good life for him in this dunya. At every moment his focus will be on akhirat, which was the condition of Sahaba Ikram. رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين. And if we take the other ayat of the Quran, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكًا وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. That man who disobeyed Allah, Allah says we will give him a narrowed life. The ulama here again have debated, if we look at the life of a kafir, it is a vast life. And Allah says he will be given a narrowed life. What does Allah refer to as a narrowed life? When the kafir who has transgressed all the limits of Allah has the most vast life in our apparent view, what we can see around us. Sa'id ibn Jubair rahimahumullah, which Mufti Shafi Sahib rahmatullah alayhi quoted in his Ma'arif al-Quran, on the authority of this tabi'i. He says, what is meant by ma'ishat and dhanka, a narrowed life, despite owning everything, Allah Pak will deprive him of contentment. So he will own an empire, but till he will not take the sleeping pill, his eyes will not close. Who's more lucky, brothers? The man who's living hand to mouth, who's living hand to mouth, who doesn't have his own house, he's renting. Nobody owes him, he owes no one. But he sleeps so deep that if he doesn't on the alarm, he won't get up. And this man is in such parishani that until he doesn't take the sleeping pill, there's no question of him falling off to sleep. Who is the king? The man who doesn't have control over sleep. What control does he have over the dunya? Who cannot bring sleep to himself. And this man is such by, he has to put the alarm and tell this one, you better phone me, you better tap me, and you better on that alarm. Me, I sleep very deep. Who has peace? Who has life? Brothers, we have been, the nazam that was read, the fashion has made us blind. Everybody is running. The question is, how long are we going to run this way? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Mu'az, in aratta aisha suhada, wa meetata shuhada, wa najata yawm al-hashri. O Mu'az, in aratta aisha suhada, if you want an honorable life in this dunya, and you want the death of a martyrdom, wa najata yawm al-hashri, and you want salvation on the day of Qiyamah, when some will be saying, Ya waylana man ba'athana min marqadina, who woke us up from this grave? Some will be saying, هَذَا مَا وَعَدَ الرَّحْمَانِ وَصَدَقَ الْمُرْسَلُونَ. This is the day we were desiring, anticipating, and anxiously awaiting. Some will be saying, قَالُوا رَبَّنَا غَلَبَتْ عَلَيْنَا شِقْوَتُنَا قَالُوا رَبَّنَا غَلَبَتْ عَلَيْنَا شِقْوَتُنَا وَكُنَّا قَوْمًا ضَالِّينَ. Oh Allah, our evil overpowered us, take us out. قَالَ اخْسَأُوا فِيهَا وَلَا تُكَلِّمُونَ. Allah will say, silent, there is no chance of you coming out of here. Some will be saying this, some will be saying that. O Mu'az, if you want peace on that day, protection from Faza'ul Akbar, the supreme horror, وَالنَّجَاةَ يَوْمِ الْحَشْرِ وَالْأَمْنَ يَوْمِ الْخَوْفِ, security on the day of fear. What security can the security of this dunya offer? وَالْأَمْنَ يَوْمِ الْخَوْفِ وَالنُّورَ يَوْمِ الظُّلُمَاتِ, light on the day of darkness. يوم يقول المنافقون والمنافقات للذين آمنوا انظرونا نقتبس من نوركم. When the kafir and the munafiq will tell the believer, we are in so much darkness, we can't walk. Just look at us, your face is so radiant. By you looking at us, we will find our direction. It will be said, قيل ارجعوا وراءكم. Go and move, there's no light for you. بشر المشائين في الظلم إلى المساجد بالنور التام يوم القيامة. Give glad tidings to those men who frequent the masjid in the hours of darkness, of perfect light on the day of Qiyamah. والنور يوم الظلمات والظل يوم الحرور. And you want shade. Whose shade? Allah's shade. Which day when the sun will be above your head? والري يوم العطش. And quenching your thirst on the day of thirst. Whose water? The water of Nabi alayhi salam. أَكْوَابُهُ عَدَدَ نُجُومِ السَّمَاءِ. The utensils equivalent to the stars in the skies. مَنْ شَرِبَ شُرْبَةً لَمْ يَزْمَعْ بَعْدَهَا أَبَدًا. Whoever will take one sip will never experience the agony of thirst again. عَيْنًا فِيهَا تُسَمَّى سَلْسَبِيلًا. The river of سَلْسَبِيلًا. كَأْسٍ مِّن مَعِينٍ. The spring of Ma'in. يُسْقَوْنَ مِن رَحِيقٍ. The spring of Rahiq. And Allah make us among those fortunate people who Allah says, وَسَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ شَرَابًا طَهُورًا. They will be those whom Allah himself will give water and say, oh my banda, are you happy what I've kept for you? The real kamyabi is Jannat. In this dunya, a man can own everything, but there's someone that is making hasad for him. How can you stop that? How can you stop hearing something you don't want to hear? But it's another man's tongue, how are you going to stop him? That is why the Quran says, when the jannati will enter, وَقَالُوا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي أَذْهَبَ عَنَّ الْحُزَنِ إِنَّ رَبَّنَا لَغَفُورٌ شَكُورٌ. Allah has removed grief. Now there will be different ranks in jannat. Some will be in the lowest jannat, some will be in the highest jannat. But Allah says, don't worry. وَنَزَعْنَا مَا فِي صُدُورِهِمْ مِنْ غِلٍ إِخْوَانًا عَلَى سُرُرٍ مُتَقَابِلِينَ. I will remove malice, hatred, jealousy. So a man will see someone higher than him in Jannah, but he won't be jealous for him. Then Allah says, sometimes you have to hear something undesirable from someone. Allah says, don't worry. لَا يَسْمَعُونَ فِيهَا لَغْوًا وَلَا تَأْثِيمًا إِلَّا قِيلًا سَلَامًا سَلَامًا. You will only hear peace amongst yourself. Allah says, the malaika will come. وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يَدْخُلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ بَابٍ سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِمَا صَبَرْتُمْ فَنِعْمَ عُقْبَ الدَّارِ. Peace amongst themselves. Peace from the malaika. And brothers, the climax of joy will be سَلَامٌ قَوْلًا مِنْ رَبِّ الرَّحِيمِ. Allah himself will greet his banda. Say, oh my Ahmad, oh my Yusuf, oh my Fatima, are you happy with what I have prepared for you? The joy that there will be in Allah's greeting, a man will forget all the bounties of Jannah. Ibn Kathir says, for 40 years, his eyes will be glued at the countenance of Allah. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam asked Allah, Allah cast his tajalli on that mountain. With reference to Tirmizi Sharif, Nabi alayhi salam said, Allah cast a fraction of his countenance equivalent to the tip of my baby finger. How much did Allah cast on that mountain? A fraction of my baby finger. The effect of that countenance was, the Quran says, جَعَلَهُ دَكَّى. It shattered into pieces and Musa collapsed. Can you imagine when you and I, with these napak eyes, will be seeing Allah in His totality? What would be the climax of joy? And the Quran says in the same breath, the greatest regret for a kafir, wallah, on that day will be, كَلَّا إِنَّهُمْ عَنْ رَبِّهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَمَحْجُوبُونَ. That the kafir will be deprived of seeing his own Allah. He will tolerate Jahannam and the punishment of Jahannam, but he will be deprived of the sight of his own Allah, which itself will be a great torment. O Mu'az, if you want peace on that day, وَالْهُدَىٰ يَوْمَ الظَّلَالَةِ, and guidance on the day of deviation, فَدْرُسِ الْقُرْآنِ, hold on to the book of Allah, فَإِنَّهُ ذِكْرُ الرَّحْمَانِ, the best form of remembering Allah, bring in the obedience of Allah. Man ata'a Allah faqad zakara Allah, wa in qallat salatuhu wa siyamuhu wa tilawatuhu lil Quran kanzul ummal, wa man asa Allah falam yadhkurhu wa in kathurat salatuhu wa siyamuhu wa tilawatuhu lil Quran. The one that has obeyed Allah has glorified Allah, even if he does not perform optional prayers in abundance. And the one that has disobeyed Allah has not remembered Allah, even if he's finishing tasbih after tasbih, making the zikr of Allah. What is the zikr of Allah? The awareness of Allah. What is the awareness of Allah? The obedience of Allah. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, hold on to the Quran. Is that in the dunya? Is that when we leave this dunya? The riwayat of Kanzul Ummal, Idha mata sahibul Quran. When the boy who has preserved the Quran leaves this dunya, أَوْحَ اللَّهُ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ, Allah inspires that qabrastan and that grave where this amanat will be lowered. أَلَّا تَأْكُلِي لَحْمَهُ, قَالَتْ إِلَهِ كَيْفَ أَأْكُلُ لَحْمَهُ وَكَلَامُكَ فِي جَوْفِهِ. Allah tells the earth, kings and emperors and rulers will come, those that use deodorants worth thousands of rands, and open that grave after 3 days, wallah, the entire qabristan will be smelling with the odor that will come up from that body which it was a man's pride to touch or to walk close to him. The man who was dressed in garments worth thousands of rands opened that qabristan, and such an odor that the entire graveyard will be smelling. But when this hafiz will be lowered in the grave, my Nabi said 1400 years ago, Allah first tells that ground, أَوْحَ اللَّهُ إِلَى الْأَرْضِ أَلَّا تَأْكُلِي لَحْمَهُ, you dare feed on the body of this hafiz. قَالَتْ إِلَهِ كَيْفَ أَكُلُ لَحْمَهُ, wallah, you are reprimanding me, you are admonishing me, how can I ever take the guts of doing it when he's got your kalam? There's no question of me touching his body. How can I even entertain the thought of Allah when your words are there? How can I come close? I will make his ikram and his izzat. Izzat in this dunya, under the commentary of this verse, where Allah Pak says that when insan comes in this dunya, وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُتَوَفَّى وَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يُرَدُّ إِلَىٰ أَرْضَلِ الْعُمُرِ, that you are then categorized into 3 categories. Allah speaks about it in detail. ثم خلقنا النطفة علقة. We made that filthy fluid into blood clot. فخلقنا العلقة مضغة. We made it into piece of flesh. فخلقنا المضغة عظاما. We made it into bone. فكسونا العظام لحما. And then we put flesh over it. And till this stage it was it. It wasn't human. It was it, it, it. ثم جعلناه ثم أنشأناه خلقا آخر. Then from it we made it insan. We placed the ruh. فجعلناه سميعا بصيرا. We made him one that could see. We made him one that could hear. Then we took him out. How? والله أخرجكم من بطون أمهاتكم لا تعلمون شيئا وجعل لكم السمع والأبصار والأفئدة. Helpless, innocent, he can't do anything. Then Allah says, some of you we took away in this dunya before reaching the age of his strength. ومنكم من يتوفى ومنكم من يرد إلى أرض للعمر ثم لتبلغوا أشدكم ثم لتكونوا شيوخا. Some went till the age of his strength, 15, 20. And some Allah says, we take them right up to old age. And whoever we give old age to, وَمَن نُعَمِّرْهُ نُنَكِّسْهُ فِي الْخَلْقِ. If we give him old age, we repeat childhood with him in his old age. لِكَيْ لَا يَعْلَمَ بَعْدَ عِلْمٍ شَيْئًا. So that he understands. You came ignorant, you're going ignorant. Don't be deceived with what you had for a temporary period. And that also we gave. وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. We gave you. And on top of it, وَلَئِنْ شِئْنَا لَنَذْهَبَنَّ. We'll snatch it also. It's our choice. He becomes arrogant about his profession. And when he leaves this dunya, he becomes ignorant about his basic necessities, never mind his profession. He can't differentiate between his son and his grandson. And there was a time he was boasting about his profession. The profession is one side, he can't differentiate, is this night and day? Is this my son or is this my grandson? Is this my daughter or is this my granddaughter? ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ. We will take him to that age where we will repeat childhood with him. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. The Nabi of Allah has asked Allah protection from such old age where a person loses his faculties, where a person loses his sight, where a person loses his hearing. Nabi alayhi salam has repeatedly asked Allah Pak protection from this. Ikrama, I'm quoting on the authority of Ikrama rahmatullah alayhi, under the commentary of this verse, illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat, ay illa alladhina qara'u al-Qur'an. Those that will make the Qur'an their guidance, read the Qur'an, practice the Qur'an, implement the Qur'an, Allah Pak will keep all their ni'mat and restore all their ni'mat until they leave this dunya. In the riwayat of Kanzul Ummal, man adama an-nazra fil mushaf mutti'a bi basarihi ma dama fi dunya. He who will constantly look in the Quran, Allah Pak will strengthen his eyesight and Allah will preserve his eyesight as long as he lives. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, u'tu a'yunakum haddaha min al-ibada an-nazra fil mushaf. Give your eyes a share of ibadat. Eye is that organ through which we do wrong and we don't do good. The tongue, we speak wrong and we make zikr. But the eyes, we're only looking at wrong. How much ibadat do we do? Nabi alayhi salam says, allow your eyes also to make the ibadat of Allah by looking in the Quran. My respected brothers and elders, I can speak like this really, not on my own strength, on what is in Quran and Hadith. The Quran and Hadith is filled. The message that is to be taken from our program tonight is that we have to come back onto the divine guidance of Allah and Allah's Rasul. Man's thinking is full of error. Man is trial and error. He tries this, then he does this. He tries this, then he does it. Allah's everything is divine. Allah's every quality, Allah's every... لا يشغله سمع عن سمع ولا قول عن قول. Man has two ears and he cannot listen to two people at one time. Allah is free from ears and Allah listens to the entire creation. باختلاف لغاتها ولهجاتها. One person, not two people. One person speaks to us in our language but a different accent, it becomes difficult to comprehend. I know personally when I was in Australia, when the brothers used to phone home, at times I don't know was I answering right or wrong because I didn't know what he was saying. A person speaks in your own language, one person but a different accent only, and our knowledge is defeated. Man is arrogant about his knowledge. You ask him, how many eyes? I got two. How many ears? Two. How many strands of hair on your body? When were you born? I was born in 1945. When will you die? Where were you born? I was born in South Africa. Where will you die? Defeated. His knowledge is finished. Helpless. His faculties are exhausted. What gives man arrogance? And Allah says, that he is controlling the skies and the earth. If he wanted, he could compel man on guidance also. But Allah gave man a choice. For nothing else. Hunger for food, Allah gave man no choice. There's something like hunger that will force you to eat. For drinking, man has no choice. You won't drink. Thirst will compel you to drink. A person doesn't want to sleep 1 day, 2 days, 3 days. Tiredness will compel you to sleep. But Allah hasn't done so with hidayat. Allah has given us a fair chance. A man makes zina, nobody is going to hit him that now he thinks immediately. Allah has given us a chance. Allah has given us an opportunity. Brothers, we are going to be answerable before Allah. Allah give us the tawfiq and the ability of holding fast onto the divine guidance of Allah and Allah's Rasul. Allah give us the tawfiq of implementing everything that was said. Allah give us the ability to look with the eye of Nabi alayhi salam. مَا نَحَلَ وَالِدٌ وَلَدًا أَفْضَلَ مِنْ أَدَبٍ حَسَنٍ. Nabi alayhi salam says, every father is giving a prize and a gift. No father has given his son a better prize and a better gift than good manners. We make dua to the Almighty Allah. He make our children the coolness of our eyes. And may Allah protect us from all the fitnas that are surrounding us, the fitnas that are yet to come. Allah keep us with our iman, our children, our generations to come. And may Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala give us the ability of practicing the correct religion and projecting and promoting the correct religion. Wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Recite Durood Sharif. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursaleen. Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اجعل اجتماعنا هذا اجتماعا مرحوما وتفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا ولا معنا شقيا ولا محروما. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم اجعل أولادنا برا تقيا وأنبتهم في الإسلام نباتا حسنا. اللهم اجعل أولادنا برا تقيا وأنبتهم في الإسلام نباتا حسنا. اللهم طيب لنا كسبنا وقنعنا بما رزقتنا. اللهم طيب لنا كسبنا وقنعنا بما رزقتنا. اللهم طيب لنا كسبنا وقنعنا بما رزقتنا. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من زوال نعمتك وتحول عافيتك وفجاءة نقمتك وجميع سخطك. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. اللهم ما قصر عنه رأينا ولم تبلغه مسألتنا من خيري الدنيا والآخرة فاجعل لنا منه أوفر الحظ والنصيب. اللهم إنا نسألك من خير ما سألك منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم ونعوذ بك من كل شر ما استعاذك منه عبدك ونبيك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أنت المستعان وعليك البلاغ ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. رب ارحمهما كما ربيانا صغيرا. رب ارحمهما كما ربيانا صغيرا. رب ارحمهما كما ربيانا صغيرا. وصلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.